Nikki and Stitches is a craft website that really has three different components. There's one side where I post DIYs and tutorials for crafts of all mediums. The other side is that I teach online craft classes. And the third piece is that I do sell some finished products on Etsy. It really started just as a blog where I was going to post my ideas for craft projects, and from there it's grown bigger than I ever thought that it would. I think that an email campaign is the best way to take advantage of the people that are coming to your site. I think to have people come and not leave any footprint behind is kind of a waste of them coming there in the first place. I think of my email campaign as a community that I'm building. I feel like it starts with the first email that I send them. They get to know me, and it continues every time I make contact with them. I've absolutely been able to see my subscriber list grow. I think that's one thing that people have to know, is that people are going to jump off your list. What makes sense to me is that if every broadcast I send out is sent to more people than the one before, then I must be doing something right. More people are leaving their email addresses. Regardless if people are jumping off, if I'm netting a positive growth, I'm doing something right. I can say that the biggest thing that has happened to my site and the biggest thing that has given me the reach that I've gotten has been putting the pop-up to collect emails and, you know, to collect information for people that visit the site. And I know people cringe at this and people say, oh my gosh, you have a pop-up. Isn't that aggressive for your, you know, just a craft site? It is not aggressive at all. For you, it's a craft site. For me, it's my business. And I need to think of it that way as a businesswoman, where I need to capture that information. And it really is the best way to grow your subscriber list, to grow the community, and continue the conversation with people. Every blog post that I put up also gets sent out. And then there really are two other reasons why I send out emails. One would be if I was doing a sale in my Etsy shop, and the other would be for my online classes. So before the semester launches and enrollment opens, I'll send out a couple like warm-up emails and some sneak peeks as to what's coming in the classes. And what's nice too is I can segment my list, and I'll ask people that are already subscribers or that are visitors to the site, if you really want information for classes, sign up to this list. And again, that narrows down the people I'm talking to, but I know that they're there for that specific reason. It's so hard to stand out on Etsy because there are so many sellers. So for me, the one thing that I know that I have control over is my customer service. So I can't control how people find me. I can't control how they search on Etsy to get to my site. But what I can control is the relationship and the experience they have once they find me. So for me, customer service is the most important thing. Everything is personalized, from the email thank you that I send them to a handwritten note I put in with every piece that gets ordered. I think that that's the most important thing. And that relationship is what's going to keep people coming back. I think the biggest thing for people that are starting off is to not say to themselves that, oh, I'm just starting off, so I don't need to worry about marketing. I don't need to worry about, you know, email campaigns or anything like that. You do, because when I think back to all the people that I missed out on because I didn't have that, you know, pop-up or the subscriber box in my widget area on the side, like, I think, oh my goodness, I missed out on so many people. So just because you're a small blog doesn't mean you don't need those basic fundamental things to get started.